A very good morning to all of you. Myself, Dr. Varun Narayan Mishra, and today I am going to discuss about object-oriented database management system, which is an important part of database management. Okay, so outline of today's lecture is that first we will discuss about the types of database, then object-oriented database objects, the comparison of object-oriented database and relational database management system, then final the concluding remark of today's lecture, and finally we will have some references. Okay, so as all we know that there are several types of databases are available. Some of them are hierarchical data model, network database, relational database, and object-oriented database. So in the previous classes, we have discussed about hierarchical data model or hierarchical database, network database, and relational database. Today, we will discuss about the object-oriented database, how it works, and what are the advantages and disadvantages of object-oriented database. So now moving to the next slide. So first we would like to describe that what are the differences between the existing database model, or the you can say the difference between the existing model and the object-oriented database model. Okay, so as we know that the first database system was started in early 60s, and that was used as a hierarchical arrangement where the whereas for example the parts were stored as a sub-element of the supplier that supplied them. The approach had several disadvantages that includes the introduction of an unnecessary degree of asymmetry. So database management system, or you can say the concept of database, started in early 60s, and initially it was used as a hierarchical arrangement, and that is a part of the storing of sub elements of the supplier that supplied them. Okay, but it is also having several disadvantages, like it is having unnecessary degree of asymmetry. So to overcome the problem of asymmetry, the network database model was discovered in mid 60s that came into the practice. These were mainly pointer based structures, and querying and transversal was a low level procedural affair. So to overcome the problems of asymmetric things in the hierarchical data model, the network database model was started in mid 60s, and these network databases are mainly based on the pointer based structures, and in the network data model the querying and transversal process was a low level procedural affair. Now then in the 1969 the relational database system was discovered and was very soon recognized as a drastic simplification over the previous models. Okay, the disadvantages or the shortcomings of the network data model, hierarchical data model, was solved by applying the relational database model, relational database system. It was started in 1960s. So everyone agreed that relational was a good thing. The relational database model, the relational database system, was considered as a good and efficient database model. However, it took a good decade before the commercial systems could catch up with the theory. So it is most widely used database management system, and most of the people are using relational database management system or relational database model for various applications. The late 80s, there was an emergence of object-oriented database system. After the relational database model, in late 1980s, we have the new kind of database system that is known as object-oriented database system, as a response to the requirement of the applications like CAD, which dealt with many complex nested objects. Okay, so the major advantage of object-oriented database is that it can be applied so that it can deal with many complex many complex and nested objects. The field is still evolving very rapidly, and although everyone agrees that some degree of objectness is useful, there is no unanimous consequences of that exactly on the object-oriented DBMS. OODBMS means object-oriented database management system. Okay, so this new database system was emerged in 80s, and it was previously worked as a important database system to deal the complex objects. Okay, and the field is continuously growing, continuously increasing its importance in the current time, and it is also known as OODBMS, that is Object Oriented Database Management System. Okay, so there is an example of how the relational model of a CAT. Here is an example how we can apply relational database model of a CAT. So these are different parts of a CAT. At query time, try to put things together as you want. Okay, so in relational database model, we have different kinds of information about an object, but we don't know how to combine these objects to make a proper inference or to make a proper object. Okay, so in relational database model, suppose this is an example of a CAT. This figure is showing different parts of the CAT. Now this is a kind of relational data model of for a CAT. So at a query time, we have to try to put things together as we want to have a complete structure of a CAT. Now moving to the next slide, when we go to the next slide, so object oriented model can be very much useful. It can be applied to create a complete complete structure of a CAT by integrating all the components which was shown in the relational database model. So this is a best example of object oriented model, how we can use object oriented database to create a complete information of an object. And it is also important to note that here relational database model only deals with the different parts. It only deals with the relation of different parts of a CAT. It may have legs, it may have eyes and other things of a CAT. Okay, but how we can combine these parts to get complete information, to complete a structure of a CAT, it can only be possible with the help of object oriented model, which is known as OO model. Okay, so this is the way we can apply object oriented database model for creating the complete information, for getting the complete information about a complex object. Now moving to the next slide. So what is object oriented database? The object oriented database is also known as OODBMS in short. These are a kind of database management system which is based on an object oriented data model, which was inspired by object oriented programming languages. The database management system, or you can say the object oriented database management system, is based on the object oriented programming languages, and such kind of database management system are capable of storing the complex objects. For example, the objects that are composed of other objects and or multi-valued attributes. So when we are dealing with the objects which is having some complexities, or which we are having multi-valued attributes, if we are dealing with object which is having multi-valued attributes, or you can say the multi-characteristics of an object, can be analyzed very easily by using object-oriented database model, which is known as OODBMS. Okay, so moving to the next slide, these are some important features, these are some important characteristics of object-oriented database model. First important feature is that it is user-defined data type, means user have the total control to define the data type, what kind of data types you are going to use, whether you are going to use numbers, whether you are going to use strings, whether you are going to text. Okay, so it is totally dependent on the user-defined database. It is having nested objects. It contains different sets, different lists or bags, and it is also having the facility for applying different methods like precursor and stored procedures. It also preserves the strong typing across the interface. Okay, so these five features are very important to define any object-oriented model, or to describe any object-oriented or OOD, object-oriented database management system. Okay, and one of the important feature of object-oriented database model is that it is having user-defined data types. You can define the data types as per your requirement. It is also having different containers, like it can include the sets, lists or bags. It is having several methods. It can be applied by several methods like precursor and stored processes. It can preserve the strong typing across the interface. So these are some important features of object-oriented database model. Okay, so now what are the key benefits of object-oriented database management system, or we can say ODBMS? Okay, so sharing of database is very important feature of any kind of database management system. So sharing in highly distributed environment, you can share the database using ODBMS, and it is easy to share and distribute the objects than the table. When we are having the data in the form of tables, when we are having the information in the form of relational table, so it is not very much easy to share the information stored in the table. Whereas when we convert this information into some objects, so it is very easy to share the information which is distributed as a form of objects. So in this figure, you can see the comparison between object-oriented database management system or relational database management system. So in ODBMS, you can have some useful objects in the form of some circle, and these are some unneeded objects. Whereas in case of relational database management system, these are kind of table. Okay, so table is having some information. Table is filled with some information, but this table is not very much useful. This is not very convenient to be shared over the network. So if we are having the limited memory, if we are having the limited available memory, so it is not convenient to share your data in the form of table. So this is the way we can apply object-oriented or object-based data. We can convert, or we can we can transform our information in the form of some objects. Then it will be easy to share these kind of objects, that is object-oriented database management system. Okay, so these are some key benefits of object-oriented database management system, and it is very important to see here. In case of relational database model, all the information are stored in the form of tables. Tables are also known as relational table. The information is stored in the form of rows and columns. Whereas in object-oriented database management system, the information is stored in form of some objects. It may be any kind of object, it may be any shape. Okay, so it is very easy to distribute these kind of objects in comparison to the information stored in the table. Okay, these are other benefits of object-oriented database management system. Okay, it can use the memory in a better way. Okay, and it can bring only the objects of interest, and object-oriented database can reduce the need for paging B. Okay, so it can utilize the available memory in a good manner, so that there is no problem of the storage of the the storage problem or memory problem. And it brings all the objects of interest as a object-oriented database that can reduce the need for paging B. So here the black circles, the black dark circles, are some of the objects that is shared between different processes and users. So these are some kind of information that is stored in the form of some dark circles, and it is connected with different kinds of processes, different kinds of users, and multiple users can access the same information over network, or the information can be shared over the different network, or you can say it can bring the entire objects of the interest in the database, so that it can reduce the need for extra page, or it can reduce the need of extra memory to store that information or to store that data. So these are some key benefits of object-oriented database management system. Okay, so what are the strengths of object-oriented database management system? So it is having rich type system. It is better at modeling the complex objects. If we are dealing with some complex objects, if we are having very complex databases, so it is better to apply, it is better to use object-oriented models to model that complex information in the form of objects. It can perform better on certain data structures, and there is no impedance mismatch in case of object-oriented database management system. So we can see here that object-oriented database management system is very much important when we are going to model complex objects. Suppose in case of GIS, if we are having a large number of data sets in the form of point, line, and polygon, and if we are dealing with large number of data sets, so it will be difficult to model such kind of complex data sets. So in that case, the object-oriented database management system can be very much useful to model such kind of complex data sets. Either we are dealing with point feature, a line feature, or polygon feature. And it can perform better on certain data structures. As we know that data is stored in the form of different structures. So it can better performance on certain data structure, and it is having different types of systems. And there is no possibility of the mismatch of the database when we are dealing with object-oriented database management system. So these are some strengths of object-oriented database management system. And you can see, or you can say that the object-oriented database management system is very much important, very much efficient in comparison to the relational database management system, because relational database management system only supports some specific data structure. Okay, but this object-oriented database management system can support some other data structures, and it can easily used to model the complexities of the object or complexities in the database. Now moving to the next slide. Okay, so it is very important to know here what is object. When we talk about object-oriented database management system, so important term is here objects. So objects are used in object-oriented languages such as C++, Java, and others. So the object-oriented programming languages was first started at C++ and Java, and the objects are basically consisting of the following attributes. Like when we talk about any object means it should consist some of the characteristics, some of the properties of that database, that is known as attributes. So what is attribute? Attributes are the data which defines the characteristic of an object. The data may be simple, such as integer, it may be string, or it may be real numbers, or it may be a reference to a complex object. So in case of object-oriented database management system, objects are basically some kind of information, or you can say objects are having some kind of data sets that is having some attributes, that is having some characteristics. That characteristics may be any kind of data. It may be the integers, it may be strings, or it may be any real numbers, or it may be a reference to a complex object. This is all about the objects. So in object-oriented database management system, objects are very important to define before doing any kind of modeling, or before doing any kind of practices on object-oriented database management system. You should first define what objects you are going to deal with, or what are the characteristics, what are the attributes of certain type of objects in your database management system. You have to also define the data type, what kind of data type you are dealing with, whether it is integer or in string, or it may be a real number. You have to define the data type before doing any kind of database management system related practices. Okay, now moving to the next slide. So for object-oriented database model, we need to apply some methods. So how many types of methods are, or you can say which type of methods are important to define object-oriented database management system? So the methods that is used to define the behavior of an object and are what are formally called procedures or functions. Okay, method means we need to apply some procedure or function. The function may be of any type. Function may be Boolean operation, function may be any kind of logical operation, function may be any kind of arithmetic kind of function. Okay, so the method includes any kind of procedure or function. Therefore, the objects contain both executable code and the data. So for running the object-oriented database model for applying object-oriented database model, we should have some codes and data sets so that we can easily execute the code on that database. There are other characteristics of the objects, such as whether methods or data can be accessed from outside the object or not. So there is an important term is accessibility of the database. Whatever the data you are dealing with in the object-oriented database management system or object-oriented data modeling, it is very important to see whether the access is available from the outside of the object or not. If we are having different kinds of objects, different kinds of databases, so it is very important feature of any kind of database management system, so that we have to provide the necessary access to the users. So during applying any method or at the time of the applying execution of the method, we have to be ensured that whether methods or the data sets that are used in object-oriented database modeling can be accessed from outside the object or not. So it is very important that we should have the access to the data set by some users, or different users may have the access to that database. So this is all about the methods that is used for object-oriented database modeling. So now another important question is that when to use object-oriented database. Okay, we are having different kinds of databases, we are having different kinds of methods for managing the databases: hierarchical database, network database, relational database. So, but it is important to know when we are going to apply or when we should apply object-oriented database. So the object-oriented databases should be used when there is a complex data or complex data relationship. Okay, if there is a complexity in your database or it is very hard to see the relationship between the data sets, then we can use object-oriented database model. This includes many-to-many object relationship. Okay, as we know that relationship may be of any types: one-to-one, one-to-many, or many-to-many. So out of all the relationships, the object-oriented database should include many-to-many relationship, or you can say many-to-many object relationship. Okay, so two criteria is very important when while applying the object-oriented database. First, you should check whether your data is having what kind of complexity is there. If the relationship is very complex to define, if you are not able to find any kind of relationship in your database, so we can go for the object-oriented database or object database management system. And second important criteria for using the object-oriented database is that it includes the many-to-many object relationship. The object databases should not be used when there would be few join tables and there are large value of the simple transactional data sets. Okay. So when we are having very few join tables and there are large volume of the simple transactional data sets, so in that case, object-oriented database will not work. We should avoid using object-oriented database in case of the large volume of simple transactional data sets or in case of few join tables. Okay, so two important parameter for using object-oriented database is that data set should have the more complexities in comparison to the relational database. It is having more complex relationships and it includes many-to-many object relationship. If these two criteria fulfills, then we can use object-oriented database or object-oriented database management system, OODBMS. Okay, now moving to the next slide. So why object-oriented database should be used? What are the need of object-oriented database? Because object-oriented databases are good at handling the BLOB, and the new world of the information is all about BLOB. BLOB means binary large object. Okay. When we are dealing with the BLOB kind of data sets, right now most of the information in the world is dealing in the form of BLOB. BLOB means binary large objects. Like most of the information is in the form of images, the video, audio, animation, or maybe different kinds of mixed media sets. So if we are dealing with such kind of information, or if we are dealing with any image, if we are dealing with any video, any audio, any kind of animation, so this kind of data set is known as binary large objects, BLOB. And because of this, object-oriented database is very good to handle such kind of BLOB, like you can say binary large objects. So in case of BLOB, we should apply object-oriented database because it can easily handle such kind of data sets that will have images, the videos, the audio, animations, or different kinds of mixed medias. Okay, so how this object-oriented database is different from relational database management system? Okay, because Before the development of object-oriented database management system, relational database management system is widely used for different applications. So we should know how this object-oriented database is different from RDBS, that is relational database management system, and what are the advantages and disadvantages of object-oriented database management system. So an OOD, or you can say object-oriented database, and its database management system, that is, you can say OODBMS, object-oriented database management system, is aware of how to access or extract the internal components of an object. For an example, one or two frame of a video. If you want to extract some part of a video, if you want to extract some components of an object may be any video or audio. So in that case, object-oriented database management system can be very much useful. Or second, in the second way, that is how to execute operations or the functions against objects without exporting them to the client. Okay, so when we are dealing with any kind of BLOB, so BLOB can be easily handled by object-oriented database management system, and OODBMS helps us to extract or to access some internal components of an object. If you want to extract some part of a object, or if you want to extract some part of a database, that database may be in the form of BLOB, so we can use object-oriented database management system. And second is that we can execute the operations or functions against objects without exporting them to the client. This is also important property of object-oriented database management system. Okay. So we can execute any of the operation, any of the function without exporting them to the client. So these two are very important features of object-oriented database management system that makes it advantageous over relational database management system. Now moving to the next slide. There are other advantages of RDBMS or other features of object-oriented database management system. It can extract enough about the objects that will be used to develop an intelligent search plan to optimize the performance. For an example, if the users wants multiple frame of video plus information on an actor, royalties and the rights, then in that case, object-oriented database model can develop an intelligent search plan to optimize the performance. Means we can use object-oriented database model for having multiple data sets, for dealing multiple data sets, to develop a intelligent search plan to optimize the performance. The object-oriented database management system OODBMS gauges the speed of the retrieval of each item and optimizes a retrieval plan using server resources and freezing the client to continue work. Okay. So these are some features that makes object-oriented database management system different from relational database management system. Now moving to the next slide. So how data can be stored in object-oriented database model? So two basic methods are used to store any object or any data sets in object-oriented database model by different database vendor. Each object must have a unique ID, and which is defined as a subclass of a base class using inheritance to determine the attributes. And second one is that the virtual memory mapping is used for object storage and the management. So this is the way, these are the two ways to store the object or store any data in the form of object in case of object-oriented database management system. Okay, object should have unique ID, and there may be the virtual memory mapping that can be used for the object storage and the management of the objects. It can manage multiple objects at a time. It can manage multiple information in the form of objects at a time in case of object-oriented database management system. Now moving to the next slide. So this slide is showing the comparison between RDBMS and ODBMS, that is the relational database management system and object-oriented database management system. So these are some criteria on which we can compare the RDBMS and ODBMS. First criteria is support for object-oriented programming. RDBMS having poor support for object-oriented programming, whereas ODBMS have direct and extensive support for any kind of object-oriented programming. What is the simplicity of use? In case of RDBMS, the table structures are easy to understand, whereas in ODBMS, it is okay for programmers. Some SQL access can be used for end users. Extensibility and the content. So in RDBMS, there is no any availability of extensibility and content, whereas in ODBMS, the users can write different methods and in any kind of data structures. The relationship between the complexities or the relationship between the complex data sets is very difficult to model in case of RDBMS, but ODBMS can easily handle the complexities, or you can say the complex relationship between the data sets. It can handle the arbitrary complexity in any kind of database. These are some comparison of object-oriented database management system and relational database management system on the basis of four different criteria. One is support for object-oriented programming. Second one is simplicity of the use, extensibility and the content, and complex data relationship. So this is the way we can have multiple criteria that can be used for comparing the performance, or you can say the characteristics of RDBMS and ODBMS. Now moving to the next slide. So what are the advantages of object-oriented database management system over relational database management system? So first advantage is that it can reduce the paging. It can have better concurrency control, that is having a hierarchy of the object that may be logged. Data model is based on the real world. It can have the less code required when applications are object-oriented. Okay, when we use object-oriented programming, when we are going to use object-oriented languages, so less code is required for executing any program in case of object-oriented programming or object-oriented database management system. Okay, now moving to the next slide. So what are the, but there are several disadvantages are also there. So disadvantages of object-oriented database management system in comparison to RDBMS is that it is having lower efficiency when data is simple and relationships are simple. Okay, so it doesn't work on simple database or different data sets having simple kind of relationship. It can work efficiently, it can having good efficiency in modeling the complexities or complex databases. And it is having relational tables are very simple. It is having standards for RDBMS that are more stable, and it can support RDBMS that is having more certain and changes is likely, less likely to be required. So these are some disadvantages of object-oriented database management system in comparison to the RDBMS. So one of the important disadvantages is that it cannot work properly for simple kind of database. It can work efficiently for having the data sets having for the data sets having complex relationship. Okay, and it is having more, it is not more stable, it is having less stability in comparison to the RDBMS. So the conclusion of today's lecture is that the object-oriented database can deal with the complex data sets, or we can say objects which are not accessed by any of the database. BLOBs like videos, animation, and images, it can easily deal the BLOB that may have different kinds of animations, different kinds of images, different kinds of videos. So in concluding remark, we can see or we can have the information about the object-oriented database that it can deal with very complex data sets, and it can be very much useful in modeling the relationship of complex data sets. Okay, and we can say the objects which are not accessed by any of the database. So it is very important to note that when we are going to use different kinds of databases, when we are going to use different kinds of data modeling techniques, so first we should check the complexities of data type. First, we should check the relationship of such complex data sets. If it is having simple data sets, if it is having simple relationship between the data sets, so we can easily use a relational database model or any old or traditional database models. But if we are dealing with very complex data sets, there is a complex relationship among the data sets. So in that case, the traditional methods will not work properly, and we have to apply object-oriented database in that case to deal with such complex data set or to model the relationship between the data sets. And also, if we are dealing with the data set which is having some videos or some animations or images, which is known as DLOB, so in that case, we should adopt object-oriented database management system, so it can easily deal such kind of databases. Thank you very much for today's lecture. And we will meet again for next lecture tomorrow. Thank you.